Hello students, let us see program number 10 under Kozawa Programming Lab for 6th semester. So this is write a Java program to implement multi-level inheritance by applying various access controls to its data members and methods. So as the name suggests, there are two concepts here. First one is the inheritance concept, which you are already aware of, wherein we take in or inherit methods and variables from a superclass or from another class, which is called as a superclass. And the class which inherits these methods and variables is called as a subclass. So this is your inheritance. Next, there are different various kinds of inheritance. We have seen the simple version of it. Now this is the multi-level version of it. So multi-level means more than one superclasses. So for example, consider three classes, A, B, and C. So A is a superclass of B. That means B inherits from A. Now C is a will be inheriting from B. So B will be the superclass for C. Okay, but in retrospect, because B has inherited from A, C will automatically inherit from both A and B. So this is a multi-level inheritance, two level of inheritances you can see there. Okay, so now we'll see how multi-level inheritance can be applied for a simple student marks program. Okay. So I have my program code here. In this program code, let me just explain to you the different levels and classes of multi-level inheritance. Okay. So let us begin. So this one is my first class. So this is called as class person. So this is my very first class called class person. So what does this consist of? This consists of two variables, name and address, and one constructor, which takes in two parameters again, which is N and A. So assigning it to name and address. So this is your first class. Okay. Next, what do you have next? We have the second class here called Stu1, or you can say Student1. Now, this one basically is going to be having one method as well. Okay, along with the constructor, it also has a method. Now you can see here, this again has two variables, department, USN. Okay. And in the constructor, however, you can see four variables being taken, four parameters. Now, how is that possible? Simply because Stu1 is extending or inheriting from person. So person has two variables. Those two variables can also be part of your subclass constructor. So there is an inheritance occurring. So this is my superclass for this class, which is the subclass. Now subclass can mention these two parameters, name and address of person, in its constructor also. This is the benefit of inheritance in general. So now, what about the parameter values? How are they caught? D and U, department and USN, will be provided as part of the constructor itself. They can be caught using department and USN. What about N and A? We don't have name and address inside this particular class. So then how do we catch it? We will use the very powerful super. Now what super will do is, it will catch these two variables or parameters that you have passed in, and will pass these two values to the constructor of the superclass. So here we these two will be caught and passed to this constructor here. So this constructor is able to handle N and A by assigning it to name and address. So this is how inheritance works. Next, we have one method here, which is a local method for student class. Okay, it's a display. So it is going to display name, address, department, and USA. All the four things it's going to display. Next, so we have now had one superclass. So this is one superclass. Okay. Superclass. And this is supposed to be a subclass. If we stop the program here and go to main, then this will be the subclass. This will be the superclass, but we do not stop here. We are going one more level. So in which case this stu1 now becomes superclass, and we'll see which is the subclass now, which is marks. This is the subclass now called marks. Okay. This is my subclass. Now this particular subclass, as I told you before, inherits from stu1, obviously. Okay, stu1, also person, also person. What about this one? This inherits from person only. Okay. So now we have class marks called marks, and it's inheriting from stu1, which in general means it inherits from person also. So how many variables is it inheriting? Four. Two from person and two from stu1. Okay. So name and address from person, department and USN from stu1. Let's see what else we have in the marks class. We have a string subject. So this is a string with the subject. Then we have marks, and then we have total. All these are array types. Two array types also we have. Okay. Now we are going to define the constructor for marks class. See here. When we define the constructor for marks class, because we are going to do an inheritance here, this will not only consist of its own variable or parameter, but also the other four variables or parameters of stu1 and person respectively. So this consists of string s, which actually means the subject, and int m, which actually means the mark. Because of the array type, we have to declare it in this form. These two things. Now, what are these? These two are from our student class, department and USN. What about these two? Address and name. Address and name. So now these two values we'll get it from the same class, same marks class. See, I've declared it here. So I'll get it from the same class. What about these other four values? For these other four values, I'm simply going to use super. Now what will this super do? It will call on the super class constructor and pass NADU. Now, which is a superclass constructor here? Stu1. So these four values will be passed to stu1, which is the superclass constructor of stu1 class. Now, NADU is passed here, NADU. But only DU will be caught inside this constructor. N and A will again be passed to the superclass of stu1, which is person, that is here. And it will be caught inside the constructor of person. So you see how many levels we have got now? 3 levels, okay? So the marks and the subject is caught here. Next, we have to find the total marks. So simply we're going to do a total summation. We're going to use I equal to 0, I less than marks dot length. As we have seen before, length is used to get the actual length of the array. So here, we're going to get the length of the array marks. Suppose we have 3 marks. So the answer here will be 3. So I equal to 0, I less than 3 will take you to 3 loops, 0, 1 and 2. So every time you keep adding the different marks which is present in the marks array. 75, 85, 95, 3 marks, add them up, that's it. Marks of 0 will be 75, marks of 1 will be 85, marks of 2 will be 95. Add them up and you get total, that is here. And one more thing that we have here is the display function. Now, super dot this, we are calling on the super class's display function. Where is that? Super class's display function is this one. This is super class display function, so it will automatically print these two lines. Apart from that, we are going to have total marks, which also we are going to print here. We are also printing the subjects as well. For per subject, what are the marks, that also we are going to print. So the display function is, this particular display function is local to marks. But this is inherited from the superclass stu1. Now, we have our main class, which holds the main method. Inside this, we have subjects. Three subjects are there here. Physics, chemistry, maths, which is again in an array. We have 3 marks, as I told you, 89, 75, 95. So when we are going to create this object, new marks, we are going to pass 6 different parameters to the constructor of marks. So where is the constructor of marks? This is the constructor of marks. So all the values are being passed directly. See here, Alex is the name, outer ring road is the address, CSE is the department, this is the USN, sub 1 is the list of subjects because it's an array, this is chemistry maths, and marks is another array which consists of 89, 75 and 95 as the marks. So all these 6 different parameters are passed to the constructor of marks, and this then calls on super and passes it to the higher super classes. Once that is done, we are calling on to the marks class display. It's very simple because we call this display, automatically it will call the display of the superclass and plus will print all these other things. So this is your multi-level inheritance demo program. So 3 classes are there and let's see the output now. I'll just run this. Student information. This, if you see, these two are from our disk, from the stu1. Then total marks are, this is from display, subjects are along with their name and marks. So this is the output for your multi-level demo program. Hope you understood this. Thank you.